And this section, in this section I want to explain you RC phase shift oscillator. So which I was explained this previous video, which I was explained feedback, that relates this concept. Okay, this is the circuit which I designed. Okay, this is the amplifier. Okay, that's in non-inverting mode. It's not, oh sorry, it's in inverting mode. That means it's a 180 degree out of phase. So this is the section where I have used. Yeah, this is the section, this is the phase shifter. What happens, let me see that. What happens if you see this, resistor and capacitor, if you apply certain voltage, okay, Vin, what happens? What happens, this, your capacitor starts charging, right? That means it's some phase changing, right? See, it's a charge, so some phase changing. This is the 60V. Yeah, that's what does is this section. These sections we are used, that means three sections we are used. What it does means, as a each arm, we can see that. As a each arm, it changes 60 degree phase. That means this is 60 degree, this 60 is plus 120 and is in a 180. It's already is in a 180 out of phase. That out of phase, again it starts making its out of phase, 180 and 180, what happens, that's a 360, that means that's a, yeah, that's in phase of its output, right? What happens is the signal starts gain increasing, right? And it starts continuous oscillations. Yeah, that's what happens, right? Okay, let me see the design. So take the 1 kilohertz design, 1 kilohertz design. And my C is a 0.01 microfarad. Okay, let me design. This is a derived formula for RC phase shift. Okay, that's F is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC square root of 6. That's we will get almost R is a 6.5 kilo ohm. Okay, and then we can use a 6.8 kilo ohm or a 6.2 kilo ohm. That's not a big issue. And then this connect is a VCC plus VCC and this is a minus VCC. And your gain, RC phase shift gain, it should be greater than or equal to at least a 29 dB. Then you will get sufficient oscillation. But this is a very difficult to execute. That's why use this RF, this RF feedback resistor. And uses a 1 megapod or some 500 series with 10 kilo ohm and vary the pot at certain point you will get around it's a 20 to 30 dB. So again, there you get sufficient oscillation. We will see that practically in that case, that means oscillation, and we will see the exact 60 degree out of phase and 120 degree and 180 degree. The circuit which I was used 741 op amp, okay, and then this is the RC phase shift, so 0.013 capacitors are used, okay, and 6.2 kilo ohm I used, so thereby I am getting almost this wave, this is the output wave, so that's the voltage is at 23 volts, so I am getting a 23 volts. So let me, this is a pot, 1 meg pot which I have connected, so for RF, so this is a 1 meg pot, so and then, now we will connect a channel 2 for a phase shift. Let's we analyze a phase shift, that's a first phase shift is a, we can see that, that's almost 60 degree, you can observe clearly, that's a blue wave is a, your output, okay, and then this is a 180 degree. Yeah, you can see the changes. That's offset will happen because of the some tolerance, capacitor tolerance, and the resistor tolerance, something like that. You can avoid by the offset. So using a your pump pin number 1 and then pin numbers 8 offset points. You can modify that wave. So this is a 180 degree out of phase. You can see that that's exactly in phase of that. So that's exactly in phase of the input.
So say that means 180 degree out of changes means that's exact almost that same in phase of that. So yeah, this is about the circuit. So that's almost you are getting at a 60 degree phase shift. You are getting 21.6 volts. So at a 60 degree phase shift, you are getting 18.4 volts. At 180 degree phase shift, you are getting exact voltage. That's the whole. And then the frequency almost we designed that's a 1 kilohertz, but here we are getting 2.38. We can adjust thereby the port. We can adjust the port, so then we will get almost good response, wave response. But as you increase the frequency, what happens? Your gain start decreasing. That means your offset will add up that. So that we will see that. See, this is almost all RC phase shift. Okay, and then see, we can see now it's visible very good. So now we will analyze the phase. So that's logically. Oh, now you can see that's a exact 60 degree out of phase. Guys, now we can see this is visible. So that's 120 degree out of phase with that. So you can see that. That's almost output is 12.4. At 120 degree phase shift, you are getting 6.8 volts. So let me take as this is a 60 degree out of phase, and this is in phase of that. So it's exactly in phase of that. So this is how we will get, okay, and the voltage also is the same output voltage. This is how we will get RC phase shift voltage. Now we will execute the RC phase shift, and this is your analyze RC phase shift. And this is what I used. It's a 1 meg port. Around, I say, 1 meg port, around I'm getting a 500 kilo ohm. So you can use around 270 to 820 kilo ohm. In between, that means it's RF in between lies, okay, and then you will get a sufficient oscillator. Your gain is increases almost about 29, that's a plus or minus, or it's not plus or minus, it's increases, okay. Thank you for watching video, and please subscribe Silicon Brains, and thank you.